8 when the flight took off from Bole International Airport. And 6 minutes later, it got lost in terms of radar surveillance.
The pilot mentioned that he had difficulty and he wants to return. We will have to comply with the international regulation to wait for the investigation to reveal the cause of the accident.
We were sure our relative was going to come out. After a few minutes, we saw some news on Facebook and Twitter just flying Ethiopian Airlines crashes. And when we look at the time, it was the same time he was actually to leave Ethiopia.
This is JT Hickok's Watchmen Project. Please subscribe, give a thumbs up, and ring the notification bell for the latest videos and uploads. This channel is about world news and the signs of the times that we live in.
There's a twilight feel to one of the main indoor markets in downtown Caracas, but it's actually the middle of the day. Like everywhere else in the entire country, there is no power. The only light is in the fishmongers. They're the only ones here with a generator. The butcher's shops are mainly shuttered and empty. In some, though, the meat is just rotting away. Fruit and veg is available, but only with a bank card if they can get a signal or US dollars. The country's hyperinflation means there's basically no local money. Certainly not enough you could find to pay for anything. Rosa Gonzalez says this is a disaster. The fruit and vegetables are rotting without light and coolers.
We are accepting dollars. Lots of people come with dollars. We're also accepting euros and bank transfers. Sometimes we let people take the food and come back and pay another day. And if they don't come back, well, that's how it is.
Everyone is affected in Venezuela, and there's a sort of numbed shock in everyone we meet.
When you go to this kind of mercado, they sell you the food by divisas or cash.
Right.
Money cash, and nobody has cash.
No.
Some of these places, you know, I have been in my house 3 days without water, without food, without TV, without electricity, and also without communication.
This is now the longest nationwide power outage in world history. What was normally considered an absolute given in this society is falling apart, and not slowly. This is the country with the largest known reserves of oil in the world. They barely charge for it, but without power, you can't get it. It's sort of priceless now. This is the queue for one of the garages with a generator. It's miles long. Driving around the city, it's easy to see how things can fall apart. Long tunnels and out pitch dark. Communications and telephone systems have collapsed. On motorways, cars simply pull over if they find a place with a signal. People now stand in line outside supermarkets, not to go in. They're just hoping that it will eventually open. The political chaos here could soon be eclipsed by this increasingly dangerous national disaster. Stuart Ramsey, Sky News, Caracas.
Heavy fighting erupted today in Syria as U.S.-backed forces battled against the last ISIS stronghold in the country. Civil war has left Syria in ruins. Rebuilding will be a massive task, as Jonathan Bigliotti reports from the city of Homs.
5 years after the fighting stopped, the city of Homs is still trapped.
Do you have faith that the government will rebuild?
The short answer is no.
For the long answer, architect and author Marwa El-Sabouni takes me 12 stories up this burnt-out office building to see what's left of her studio.
So this was your studio right here?
Yeah, and my husband's place was there.
What used to be your office was then turned into some kind of sniper den.
Hundreds of bullet casings littered the floor, remnants of a battle that destroyed an estimated 35,000 homes.
Who do you blame for all of this?
Personally, you mean?
Yeah.
No, personally, I've taken the decision not to blame anybody. The scale of loss and the scale of atrocities makes it very possible to blame everybody.
It's estimated that more than 500,000 people have been killed in this war. Many Syrians have yet to see the full scale of loss. Traffic has jammed the Jordanian border as families who fled return to destruction. From East Aleppo, where it could take 6 years just to clear the debris, to the tourist town of Palmyra.
Palmyra is perhaps best known for its ancient ruins, but it also had a thriving new city, and that's where we are right now. And look at the sheer scale of destruction. Before the war started, 80,000 people lived here. Today we're told only 35 families have returned.
Among them, Frida Mahmoud and her son, who opened a small kebab stand.
Kyle here with the Watchman Project. So as you've seen, Ethiopian Airlines crash kills at least 150. This is the second brand new Boeing to go down in months, March 10th, 2019. Aftermath of the deadly airplane crash in Ethiopia. Okay. Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, a jetliner with passengers from at least 35 countries crashed Sunday shortly after leaving Ethiopia's capital, killing at least 157 people on board and renewing concerns about the new model of aircraft involved in the accident, the popular Boeing 737 MAX 8. Now, it probably has something to do with where they're getting the planes from, who's making the planes, because they're saying their main concerns is the changes to the plane. Okay. And it's the second one of this make and model to crash in months, not just like over a couple years in months, but the plane, the same Boeing model that went down in Indonesia in October, killing at least 189 people on board, lost contact with air traffic control 6 minutes after takeoff, and then plummeted to the ground near Bishoftu, a town southeast of the capital. Now, see how it says that it lost air traffic control 6 minutes after takeoff. Then it went down. I'm telling you right now, an electromagnetic pulse will shut your vehicle down because it shuts down several parts of it. Same thing with a plane. EMP hits, planes are falling out of the sky. Reason being, because they run off of the fuel and the electricity. The computer system will shut down. Anything electronic will be shut down. A UAV jammer. They have these UAV jammers that are like literally drone helicopters, and they can shut down anything. That's what I'm saying. For people that hit the 8X list, when martial law does come, because it's coming, and it's not going to be a good thing for Americans. I'm telling you that now. And when it does, people that are on the 8X list, high profile people, get snatched first. Within 2 weeks prior to something going on, you will see big players moved, religious leaders. You will see people, for example, conspiracy theorists with great, huge followings. These people will be gone. They won't be posting videos. They won't be doing anything because they'll be gone for 2 weeks. Also, when they come to get you, your phone service will be bad. Electricity may be flickering. There'll be tell signs that they're jamming any trace of phone or technology interfering with them snatching you. And people that are blue listed, they come for after the event. So it could be months after, it could be right after, during the event, while it's happening. But that's what they're waiting for. I really believe that we're waiting for the next September 11th. And it's going to be the same way. It's going to be initiated. It's going to be planned. It's going to be, we're due for it. It's coming up on 2020 elections. It's, that was 2001. It's been 19 years. So, they're ready. But yes, this is just, hope I was able to shed some light on this. I mean, this is a pretty heavy situation for Ethiopia. Let me know what you guys think. International Policy Digest. Okay, March 11th at 9:41 a.m. Here we go, you folks. Seven technologies set to revolutionize healthcare just in 2019. The healthcare field is ever evolving and incorporating new technologies. So doctors and other healthcare professionals have long utilized technology in patient treatment, but today's innovations trend more toward increasing patient access to care and empowering individuals to take more active roles in their health outcomes. 1. Counseling to go. Who has time for weekly hour-long sessions on a psychiatrist's couch? Online support groups, interprofessional counseling apps, which connect patients with therapists. Look, telemedicine, improving specialist access, a major issue facing patients in rural communities, involves the immense distances between themselves and specialist providers. But telemedicine, a technological innovation already used in many such communities, increase access to the specialist without patients needing to drive hours away. I mean, they're just getting to where they do it without having to go anywhere. And then cloud-based medical records. In the past, patients planning a relocation had to book a visit with their physician to obtain cumbersome paper medical records, but no longer. Many healthcare facilities now provide patients with online portals where they can review and print medical records as needed. I mean, it goes on and on. MRI imaging, look. Many patients previously relied on visits to specialists to interpret test results for anything from MRI imaging. Now, however, they can sign in and review test results well before their next trip to the doctor. This convenient option provides patients with near instant peace of mind instead of sweating out test results. AI for better health. Now it's all going to be done through AI. Even perform surgery via robot, and a trend likely to grow given the need for affordable access to surgical specialists. It's a specialist because it's a robot. I can't believe that. So consultations from the couch, better health monitoring devices, yeah, chips and other thing, ECG data, blood oxygen saturation levels, temperature, everything. All right, this just in, folks. Got police activity reported at suburban New York Hospital, March 10th, 2019, 9:56 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Bronxville, New York. There is a large police presence at a hospital in suburban New York. A person who answered the phone in administration office at New York Presbyterian Lawrence Hospital in Bronxville at about 9:30 p.m. Sunday confirmed the hospital was on lockdown.
The person would not give her name. She said she hadn't heard or seen anything and was just waiting. Video outside the hospital shows numerous emergency vehicles with their lights flashing. The Journal News reports that heavily armed SWAT teams are patrolling the area. So, something is going on in Bronxville, New York, at the Presbyterian Lawrence Hospital in Bronxville. I wouldn't be surprised if we found out something was going on. Everybody, if you know anything about the situation, please put it in the comments below. Everybody, stay awake, stay aware, and God bless you all. As you can see right here, Vav, or VW, also the number 6 in the Hebrew language. Well, when you look, if you compare World Wide Web to 666, and this is what they want us all connected to, is the World Wide Web. This is the monetary system. It even says that the number of the beast is 666. They even show you that its Arabic numeral is the same as the Hebraic, and that's why you see them doing the hand sign with the V, like Spock off of Star Trek. And the same thing with the W. It's the
Therefore you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect.
The gospel message. Your debt has been paid, you're free. That's the good news. Your debt has been paid by Jesus Christ in full, who went to the cross, whose blood was shed in your stead. The A is for admit. Admit that you're a sinner in need of a Savior. The Bible says all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. There is none righteous, no, not one, save one, Jesus Christ. The B is for believe. Believe in your heart that Jesus Christ was crucified, buried, rose again from the dead, that Jesus is Lord. And then the C, after believing in the heart, is confessing with your mouth, calling upon the name of the Lord. Romans 10:13 says, all who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved.
Thank you for watching The Watchmen Project. Please like, share, and subscribe. Stay awake and aware, and God bless you all.